Hello, my name is Stuart Tolliver, and I'm an applications engineer here at Teledyne Hastings Instruments.
Today, we will be taking a look into Teledyne Hastings' newest mass flow controller and flow meter, the 300 View. The 300 View offers fast and accurate gas control and measurement via a colored touchscreen conveniently located on the instrument. With just a 24-volt bayonet power supply, a gas supply, and your finger, you are up and running in seconds. The 300 View has a 9-pin D connector and a 3.5mm TRRS jack for analog and digital communications, respectively. The 300 View is available with many different analog input and output options, such as 0 to 5 volts, 0 to 10 volts, 0 to 20 milliamps, and 4 to 20 milliamps. All digital instruments have the ability to communicate via RS-232 and RS-485. We will talk about this later in the video. When the instrument is powered up, you will see the Teledyne logo, followed by the main screen, which will show information on the flow rate and the gas. Let's go through some of the functions of the menus now. 300 View will allow you to manually select the set point desired. By clicking the top right menu, you are brought to a numeric keypad. Depending on the internal settings of the instrument, the set point can be entered as a percent of full scale or as a flow value in display units. The valve button in the upper left-hand corner allows you to override the set point to fully open or purge or fully close the valve. The view button in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen allows the user to cycle through three different views: the flow rate, a line flow plot, which gives the user a visual indication of the flow rate via a graph, and a totalizer view, which displays the total amount of gas used since the last reset. The menu button in the bottom right-hand corner of the screen opens a list of submenus to change various settings of the flow meter or controller. You have the option to zero the instrument. This button should only be pressed if there is no actual flow and the unit is stable. Next, we have the gas button. There will always be two options here, but could be more depending on whether the instrument has multiple gas calibrations stored. If a custom gas is selected, you can change the indicated gas, units, and reference temperature and pressure. The next submenu is flow control, which will only appear if the instrument is configured as a flow controller. From here, you can change the setpoint entry mode, which we talked about earlier in the video. This allows you to enter the setpoint as a percent of full scale or as a flow value in display units. The setpoint source changes whether the instrument uses an analog or digital input signal. The soft start allows the user to enable or disable a designated ramp rate. This will slow down response time and reduce overshoot. The 1% shutdown button is a toggle selection to enable or disable whether commands below 1% are treated as 0%. The flow averaging menu allows you to enter the number of individual flow readings obtained from the flow sensor to be averaged for the flow reading displayed on the instrument. The range inputted on the keypad can be from 1 to 100, which translates to 10 to 1000 milliseconds of averaging. A larger number will result in quieter output readings and a slower response time. The serial port menu allows the user to toggle between RS-232 and RS-485 digital communications. There is a submenu for device information, which will show more specifics such as the serial number of the instrument, the analog input and output, and the calibration date. The last feature we'll talk about is the Lockscreen feature. This provides the user with a means to lock out input to the touchscreen. A numeric keypad will appear, and the user can enter a code to lock the screen. The code for all mass flow instruments is set at the factory and available upon request. This lockout function is a minimal security feature to prevent inadvertent input and is a discouragement to curious individuals. In addition to all of these intuitive features of the touchscreen display, the 300 View can be used with our free control and data logging software. A video on the functionality of this software is available on our YouTube channel.
If you have any questions or would like more information on the 300 View, please give us a call at 1-800-950-2468 or check out our newly redesigned website at www.teledyne-hi.com. Thanks for watching.